what I do is fairly easy. You just take a camera and follow your nose, you know. I mean, it seems easy to me. You don't worry about what people say because that's what they say. You don't have to write the script or worry about the wording. And you don't have to worry about who confronts who because that's what really happens. I mean, the only thing that ever bothered me was being a fly on the wall, and I didn't like to feel like a fly on the wall. I'd much rather be a friend in the room. It's witnessing, and witnessing seems to be easier than contriving or creating. You try to create a theatrical performance. It's the theater that people go to see, the theater of whatever you're showing.
The way we decide our films almost every time is that somebody who has seen one of our films walks in the door and says, you should make a film about this. And it's happened on so many films, everything from when Penny did Don't Look Back on Bob Dylan, you know, to when we did The War Room. It really works for us as documentary filmmakers to kind of go by those instincts. In the history of documentary films, the way that stories were told was very cumbersome. You couldn't just find something in real life that you wanted to tell a story about and take your camera and spend time with the person. It was very difficult, and that was the type of thing that Pennebaker and Leacock and Bob Drew and Maisels all tried to do in those early films. And I think it was an amazing accomplishment to technically innovate the type of equipment that can do that type of thing.
I started with an Aeroflex. It was a kind of war camera. And it was a good camera, but it was a little noisy. It was not a very operative portable camera. So we had to make one. We just took apart a camera that you could buy for about $300 or $400, and we just took it to pieces and replaced the gears with nylon. We did a whole lot of things to that body.
Eventually, you know, they made it so that it had a handle in the front and you could put it on your shoulder, and they moved the eyepiece, and they worked with a lot of different people in the optics and camera industry to create this type of sync sound rig that became a staple of filmmaking really up until the video camera took over.
I'm not sure what else I could do, you know? I'm kind of lost to the world of jobs. But I do like doing it. And I know that when Chris and I sit down, when we shoot a film, it's all an adventure.
It's a great honor for Penny to get the Governor's Award, and I think he really deserves it because he's one of the people that really launched a type of filmmaking that influenced so many different filmmakers, and I'm one of them.
I feel kind of honored that people have identified stuff I've done as being worthwhile. That's always, you feel good.